Hi guys, today I will be testing out a black peel-off mask with you. The mask that I'll be using today is the Beulah's mask. This is like one of the more popular ones on Amazon that I picked up a couple days ago, so I figured I would film my first impressions video, my first tryout of this mask. I've seen a bunch of videos on YouTube where people were peeling the mask off and just so much disgusting stuff will come out, which is obviously a good thing because you want that out of your skin. And I've never given it a try. I've never owned a mask like that myself, so I decided that it was time for me to give it a try. So I figured I would film my first impressions video and share it with you guys and take you on a little journey with me to test this out. So let me just read the instructions for you before we get started with this application process. Number one, cleanse your skin and use hot towel to put on the areas that have open pores slash blackheads for 3 to 5 minutes. So basically what you want to do is you want to warm up your skin and open up the pores. You can either take a shower before doing this, which is what I would do if I wasn't filming a video, or you can add a hot towel compress on your skin in those areas. Second step, to properly use this product, apply an even thin layer on face, avoiding direct contact with eyes, brows, and lips, mainly on the areas with blackheads, like nose. Three, wait for the makeup to dry for about 10 to 15 minutes. Number four, peel off the mask and use warm water to clean dry. And if possible, apply a shrink pores class skincare product. I don't have a shrink pores class skincare product, so I'm gonna be doing everything but that. So let me go ahead and open it up and see what it looks like because I'm curious. I haven't actually opened it up yet. Ooh, I'm so excited, you guys. We're gonna be testing this guy out today. Here we go. This is what the duo looks like. Like I said, I did pick this up off Amazon. This had really great reviews, so that's why I bought it. It's fairly inexpensive. It's about $15 or so, and I will be leaving the link to this down below in case you're curious to try it yourself as well. So anyway, without further ado, let's jump in and see what this peels off my nose. All right, so let's just go ahead and start applying this mask. I'm quite nervous, honestly. Ooh, comes out all black and gooey. It's pretty sticky. I'm honestly a little bit nervous. I do have a mask brush that I could use to apply this with, but because it's so thick and gooey, I figured I'm just gonna use my fingers for this. It has a really light smell to it. I would say it smells like a beauty product. It does have that kind of a tangy smell to it, but it's very, very, very light. So I know this is not the best application job I've ever done, but I think that it will do for now. I mean, this is a first impressions kind of a video, so I really don't care how it applies on my skin as much as I care about how it performs, how it dries, how it feels on the skin. I really can't feel it on my skin other than the fact that I can see black on my nose, and I can also feel this cooling sensation, which is quite nice. I enjoy it because it's a hotter summer day and I like this cool sensation on my skin, on my nose. So anyway, I'm just gonna let it dry and I'll be back in a second and we're gonna see what it looks like dry, and then we're gonna peel it off and see what comes out of my pores. I am back with my dry mask and I'm ready for the fun part of this video, aka taking this mask off. All right, so here we go. Let's go ahead and take this mask off. Before I do that though, I want to say that it took about 10 to 15 minutes for it to dry. I know I applied it a little bit thicker in some areas, so obviously those areas needed a little bit more time to dry, but overall it's, you know, it took a little while. It took more than I expected it would, but you're not really doing anything. You can literally, like, I just applied it, turned the camera off, went downstairs, cleaned up a little bit, shopped on Amazon a little bit because I want a new curling iron too. Came back up and here we are today. Okay, so it comes off pretty easily. It is quite delicate. Ooh. It does also grab onto little hairs on your face and that hurts a little bit. So just a heads up. I'm just gonna slowly start peeling it off. But you can see it comes off all in one layer, which is awesome. Ooh. Tip of the nose hurts a lot, by the way. A lot meaning like it's bearable, it's not like anything terrible or anything like that, but it does hurt. I think if anything else, this exfoliates your skin too. So let's inspect this. I really don't see any whiteheads. see hairs. So he did pull out some hairs. Now listen, I don't know if you're gonna be able to see anything, but you can see the white things. Those are white heads. So he did pull out a couple, but not as many as I thought it would. Let me just go ahead and clean my face up really quickly so I don't have a little black dots all over my face. I'll be back in a second. Alright, so let's just go ahead and talk about the mask and see if it's worth the money or not. It's an expensive fairly, and I think that it is a really cool thing to have in your beauty skincare collection because I do think it works. It did pull off some oils, some blackheads out of my nose, so it does what it's supposed to do, but it didn't pull out as many as I was hoping for. And I also think that the key to this mask is preparing your skin properly. I think making sure that your skin is warm, steamed, and the pores are nice and open, that's a big, big thing. If you don't do that, the mask isn't going to work as well, if at all. So I think that's part of the reason maybe why today wasn't as successful of a peel-off day. It's because I really didn't take a shower, and I think that's literally the best thing you can do is just take a shower, make sure your skin is nice and warm and the pores are nice and open. But it still worked, and I am happy with the results. The only thing I don't like about this mask is the fact that it does rip some of the hairs off your face. It sounds a lot worse than it is. Like, when you think of hair ripping, you think of like this unbearable pain. It really wasn't unbearable. The worst part was peeling it off of the tip of my nose. But yeah, my first impression of this mask is thumbs up. But like I said, this is my own opinion. I can't guarantee that if you do try, you're gonna like it the way I do like it, but I think that there's a good chance that you might. And again, make sure your skin is prepared for this mask, because I think half the battle is getting your skin in the right state, as in making sure your pores are nice and open. So yeah, thank you so much for coming along on this journey with me. I love you guys. Thank you for being so sweet and supportive and the best people on YouTube. I really, really mean when I say that. I love you all. I wish you all lived in my town. I really do. I want to hang out with all of you. And yeah, thanks for hanging out right now with me. And I will see you in the next video, and have an awesome day. Bye.